Readier.
Readier?
Okay.
Was that a word?
I don't think so.
Hey, okay. Everybody! It is Margaret and
Elaine.
This is my sister. If you haven't seen some of our unboxings,
like the craze and the crazy socks, that was a good one.
Yeah, yeah. Well, Elaine and I went out garage selling this morning and we got some stuff.
Yes. So let's check it out and see what we got. So she's taking me along for the ride, and I don't do this very often. So, of course, I'm like, what does this mean? What does that mean? Show me what you're doing. So she's going to kind of walk me through at the same time she's walking you through it.
Yes.
I might say something really dumb, but I don't know what I'm talking about.
So, whatever.
Yeah.
I'm used to it. It's okay. No, I'm kidding. Okay. So ready?
Yes.
Ready. And you got stuff too. So we'll have to share your stuff too.
Okay.
So I don't have any kind of order, and I only have a little bit of research done because I was like, let's just do it. Right. Yep. Let's just do it. Hey, Clearing Clutter for Clarity. Hey, My Two Cents and Shrek Attack. How's it going, everybody?
Hi.
Okay. Hi, Kathy. All right. So if you're watching this later, this is live. All right. So first up, I picked up, this was at our first garage sale this morning. Oh, I forgot that bag. It's in the other room. That big bag I bought at the first garage sale. That big leather one.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
Okay. So I got this. Hi. She's going to get it. Hi, Jessica. Hi, Carol. So I got this Barbie clock radio. It's like so. And it had the instruction manual with it. So I picked this up for $3 at a garage sale. Hi, Kathleen and Christine and Finn Fashion Plus Phoebe. Hi. Okay. So we got this for $3. And I did look this one up. It's kind of all over the place. You got it. Okay. So let me show you what I found out about the Barbie thing, Barbie car radio. And this is not the right screen share. So here's the Barbie clock radio. These are sold. So right now, Elaine, they're seeing that. They're seeing this.
Okay.
So I'm showing them that. So, they're kind of all over the board. Like this is one. Yeah, but then this with the box went for 60, 60, 50, maybe, depending on, you know, best offer. So we'll see, because, it's all over the place, right? So I'm probably going to insert a video if I still can make, you know, insert the YouTube video to show that it's working, if it's working. So, yeah.
Mm-hmm. Or we could just do the Tommy Boy thing. Ooh, 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 and then start it on fire. I'm sure somebody would buy it then.
Yeah.
Hello. I can't even pronounce your name, but hello.
That's Kunzi Coons.
Hi.
And that's Jane, and that's Purple Lily. That's
Purple Lydia. Lily. Okay. You were at our last video, weren't you, Purple Lydia? Yeah.
Yeah.
I remember you.
Hi, Diane. Okay, so next up, I picked up this bag. This is a leather bag, and it snaps open like so. Hang on, hold that
like
part.
A file folder kind of?
Yeah. It's a Randy says military, U.S. property. Mm-hmm. Only now it's Margaret's property. So it's in really good condition. Like, all the flaps are there, and so I paid $5 for that. I thought that was pretty cool.
Yeah, it still has that nice leathery smell. I mean, somebody took care of it.
It's in really good shape. So I didn't look it up. I have no idea what it's worth. But Randy may commandeer it and decide I can't sell it. Mm-hmm. So we'll see. He was eyeballing it when I brought it in. Okay. Ready? You want me to keep going?
Yep.
Okay.
See what else you got?
So some of this is just for fun. I didn't look stuff up. Hey, Polishek, how's it going? And Jessica, I know I'm like, okay, who else? Hi, John, Joanne. Nice to see you guys. So I got this rock concert. It's a rock concert. I just thought it was cute. It was 50 cents. All right.
Somebody's going to want a...
They might. It's just kitschy.
Friends,
made
right?
in the Philippines. Yeah. So some of this stuff is just kind of like, eh. Yeah.
Oh, no. Isn't that a cool bag? I love it.
Isn't it?
I mean,
isn't
you can do
it?
All kinds of stuff with that.
Yeah. Okay. Same. I think I got this also at that one. Heritage.
The Heritage one?
Yeah.
Okay.
There was a Heritage Foundation having a garage sale. And so I picked this up there too. Holy Bible. Not written in. You know, it doesn't have
pages. Yeah.
It doesn't have the family tree or anything. Pet Rock Craze. I know, right? Okay. So that was $2. I usually do pretty well with Bibles. Selling Bibles.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay. As long as they're not written in. I asked her, is there anything secret in there?
Oh, right.
Fall out?
No. Mm. But even if they're written in sometimes, they still sell.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
Anyway. Cool. So I didn't look it up. Most of this stuff I haven't looked up. So pardon. Hey, Saint Girl. All right. And then next up, I feel bad because I normally like have all this research done, but I was like, let's just do it.
Well, I want to see what everybody else has to say. Tell me what y'all think, what you think it's worth, or what she could sell it for. We'll tell you how much we paid.
Polish eggs. Margaret, yeah. What do you eat that you're so energetic? She's been with me all morning.
Salmon. And a lot of mochiata. Is that what you call it? Yeah.
Caffeine.
And drinking out of Twilight cups. That might be the secret, too.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Fueled on caffeine and salmon.
Yeah.
Hey, Joni.
Hey, that's how we get deals too at the garage sales. You know, don't brush your teeth in the morning. We were going over what we mm-hmm, should do. Mm-hmm. Don't brush your teeth mm-mm. and then have coffee breath and say, how much for that? Or I don't know if I can do that much for that. Will you take, I don't know how much. So yeah, you go by smelling like fish and coffee breath. I'm pretty sure somebody's going to just say, take it, please.
Just leave. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Yes, a dollar's fine. Yeah. Okay. Okay, so then I picked up this embroidery kit. It is open, but I think all the bits are there. I have to check to see if the needle's there, but the thread's all there. This is there, and it's a cute little girl. Oh, there goes the instructions. Little angel petting a bunny rabbit. So
does the brand matter? To the cross stitch, do y'all have any brands that sell better than others?
Like Dimensions is a brand that sells pretty good. Sometimes Sunset. It just kind of depends. Okay. I don't know this brand. Candamar Designs.
I mean, it was $15 brand new.
Yeah. So. And so it was 50 cents. I thought, okay, I could take a chance. I'll take a chance on it. Oh, you didn't. Here, this is way over here. I need to give that back to you.
Oh, yeah. Look what I found. Wow.
I think I got a new hat.
Yeah. So I love it.
Yeah.
It's my gardening hat.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Can you tighten it up?
Yeah, I'm going to.
Yeah.
I'm going to fix it.
Put some Velcro or something mm-hmm. so she what can work think? Out in her garden. Yeah. Yep. Yep. You'll rock it. You'll rock it. Let's see. Don't shower, smell bad. Clearing clutter for clarity says yes.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah. Oh, mm-hmm. we'll send you plenty of sun over here. We've got too much.
Yeah, it's pretty warm. It was almost 80 degrees mm-hmm. today. It's pretty warm. Yeah. And my 2 cents, she says subject matter counts on these. So
subject matters. Okay, cool. Yeah. Like landscape or what?
Like cats.
Okay.
Or,
okay.
You know, different.
Yeah. Well, we love cats. And by the way, did you know that I'm going to make her a crazy cat outfit? Or a crazy cat lady. We made an agreement and I'm gonna find a pink robe and I'm gonna buy little tiny like kitty cat plushes and I'm gonna sew them all over her robe and she has to wear the big plush, you know, house slippers with the kitty cats on there. And we made a deal and she has to go to a big hall and she has to wear her crazy cat lady outfit. And I bet you people will just give her deal after deal. And then she's going to become famous. And people are going to be like, did you know that the crazy cat lady visited my garage sale today? Yeah. I'm making it for her.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yes. So if you see this crazy lady out in a pink robe with cats all over her, it's a Texas gal.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah. And then what was the panther stuff?
Oh, yeah. Oh, talking about, you know, smelling bad when you go to a garage sale and you want to clear out your competition, wear some panther pee. They sell panther pee up in Kerrville to do like a deer resistance on their plant, and it smells so bad. I mean, can you imagine cat pee?
So she's going to spray me with panther pee.
I'm going to spray her with panther pee. Mm-hmm. And she's got to have that accent like, you know, Peggy from Married with Children. Yeah, that's what you gotta do. Yeah, can I have a deal?
Can I get a deal here?
Hello.
Hello. Okay. Can you come in? Okay.
Okay. Sorry. Yeah.
Okay. Okay. Top secret deal grabbers. Okay. Here we go. Oh gosh. Do you put cash in different pockets and say you only have X dollars to get a better deal? I have. I was trying that today. They wanted like $5 for this like wicker purse that I kind of wanted. And I was like, oh, you know, I can't really do that because I'm almost out of garage selling money for the day. So I don't know.
Yeah. No, I think that's a good idea. Have like a little pocket and don't show up with a big purse because then they think you have money. I wouldn't wear any jewelry, you know, any fancy jewelry to look like you have money to go out and just look really plain.
Yeah.
And then have a couple of bucks in your pocket and act real dumb.
Yeah.
And I was like, what is that? Well, I'll shoot. That's so cute. How much would you give me that for? I don't know if I can do that. Could you go down or then just go back to the coffee thing? Hey.
You're just changing accents throughout the whole thing. Like, one minute you're sound country and the next minute you're
I know. I'm confused.
You're like, get this crazy girl out of here.
It works. The psycho thing works.
Yeah.
It kind of scares people.
We were talking about that. Yeah. So this is one of the things I use sometimes. Like, it has about like two compartments. So like you could have your my bills in one side and like the change in the other. Oh, I don't know. I'm digging through my quarters. I don't know.
I get a scrap for this.
Pat says hubby just walked out laughing, heard panther pee.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Somebody can try it and tell me what they think. Bite it.
Okay. Yeah. So, all right. Moving on.
Okay.
Actual haul. I got a ship in the bottle. All right. So, try Polish accent of guy living in UK and loving US resellers. Do it.
I don't know how to do that.
It's
one.
A Polish accent.
I don't know.
I don't want to offend anybody.
I don't know.
I'm afraid it'll sound Russian.
Well,
yeah.
I don't know.
Okay, so we'll have to work on that.
Yeah, I'll look it up and I'll try to work on that.
We're working on it. Yeah. So we got this pinched bottle, Hague & Hague pinch, and there's a ship in the bottle. And I thought, okay, she wanted, I don't know, because I got three things from her, so maybe $1, right?
Yeah.
So let's take a peek at what we found out about the ship in the bottle. And we're going to come over here. What?
Oh, I just love all the comments. Oh. I love that all the people that are coming up to this live video are interacting with you. And I love to hear what everybody's saying. It's just so awesome.
Jazzy Red says, I came to Houston to see that. Okay, so this ship in the bottle sold for $18. And then we saw another one on eBay. Where did it go? Where it
right
here. Oh, here we go. Okay. So here's one that sold on auction, but this was December 5th, 25th. So it's been a while that this one sold. So let's take a peek at ones that are listed. So there's a bunch listed, not a whole bunch though. There's a few listed. So anywhere from $30 to $80. These are the same kind of style as this one we've got right here. So stop here. Wow. Hey, so I'm thinking,
I don't know, if you paid $1, you could slap $25 on it, and it'll probably sell like that. But if you want to sit on it for a while, if you've got room in your stock room, but you don't.
I'm going to put $40 on it.
Okay.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You can always
go down.
Yeah.
Right? You can't go up.
Well,
you can't go up in your price.
Watch me. Okay. No, I'm kidding. Okay. No, I'm kidding.
That ain't my business.
So, yeah, I'll probably put $40 with best offer on that.
Okay.
Yeah.
That sounds good.
Yeah.
Yeah, tell me if you sell it.
Oh, well. Let me know in a couple of years if you still have it. Might be interested.
Yeah, it might be passed down or re-gifted to somebody, but I know what you got, so you can't give me that for Christmas.
Watch
I
me.
Know.
Okay.
Yeah, sure. I like that.
This one?
The little pincushion.
Okay, so we went to a guy's garage sale, and he did storage auctions. And, like, everything she was picking up, it was like, $1. And I'm showing him, like, here, what's this? Ooh, you know, I sell on eBay, so $50 on eBay, I'd have to get at least $15-$20 from you for it. I'm like, what?
Okay.
Yeah.
So,
All right, so I picked up this. You actually showed this to me. Mm. Oh, I just realized, look, it's got a, I didn't even see that. Okay.
Cool.
So it's like a globe pin cushion. You can put your thimble on it because your thimble, it's like a thimble holder, right? And the base is a measuring tape. That is awesome.
And it came with the pins. You have to have the pins,
right?
Yeah.
Oh my gosh. Isn't that cool?
Yeah.
Okay, so I guess I'm going to sell it.
Well,
isn't
you know what?
Cool?
It would be cool if you could find some pins that were like the shape of the US or the UK, for example. Or, you know, the different shapes of
Texas.
Yeah, put Texas right
like
on there.
That'll take up half the globe.
Yeah, that'd be cool.
Woo! Isn't
that's
that awesome?
I think so.
Yeah. I'm like, does it have any more hints that I just missed? That I just like missed?
Yeah.
Like, does it stay down here? Oh, it says something.
Oh, what does it say? It says, you got a deal.
Yeah. What did I spend with that guy?
Oh, I
like
don't
eight
remember.
Bucks or something? No, this is Japan.
Okay.
Hey, cool, right?
Mm-hmm.
Quirky girl, hi, how's it going? Isn't that cute? Okay, so, Gosh, what did I spend with that guy? It was like $8 maybe for everything, or it was less. I think it was less.
I can't remember. Oh, but you got that little trinket box there.
Yeah, yeah.
Little trinket box from New York.
I got this from him too. Hi, Susan. I'm sure I'm missing people in the chat. Hi, hi. So this was also something he had. It's this little trinket box of New York. Super cute. Oh, that was in there too. So that we'll talk about that in a second. But look, it's like this pink, like enamel sort of top. And then it's a Statue of Liberty, and then
like a little brass box.
New York City. Yeah, isn't it cute? Mm-hmm. Oh, it's marked down there too. What does it say? Made in something.
Made in Japan.
Okay. Definitely vintage. I just thought it was so cute. Right? Okay, so there's that. It may not go for a ton, but you never know. And then this is broken, but I thought I'm going to get it to throw in one of my jewelry lots to show like bling.
Oh, look, she said the pincushion globe is on Etsy for $16.
Is
look,
it?
Thank you for the research.
Oh, thank you.
Yes.
Nice. I'm just thinking, it's worth more than that to me.
Like, then you better keep it.
I would keep it before I sold it for $16, you know?
Okay.
Personally.
Well, what would you sell it for?
30 at least.
30? Would somebody better really like that?
It's either, yeah, that's how much I like it.
Okay. She's keeping it.
I might be keeping it.
Yeah.
It might be going on my sewing table in the other room. Okay. Right. Because I sew too. So I don't know. I think it's cute.
Well, yeah, she'll probably end up keeping that. So, but thank you for looking it up.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Okay. And Elaine got some stuff too, but this is all mixed up. So, and again, I didn't look up hardly anything. So, all right. I got this
private.
Door, you know. Sign
that looked good on a bathroom door,
right?
Mm-hmm. Private.
It looks like it was originally $5. Somebody had five bucks on it, but I got it for a quarter. So
I don't know.
We just had fun going around.
Yeah,
right?
I did.
I mean, I don't.
And we ran into
Myra.
Okay, we ran into her twice.
Yep.
And
yep. She's in the Gulf Coast reseller group.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. It was nice to meet her.
Okay, so these are things I also got from that guy. Maybe $3. Okay, so I got this little pewter box with a star, little pewter box, and it's Heritage Pewter 1991. Again, y'all, I didn't look anything up for this whole video because why?
Yeah, that's just nice. Heavy duty.
Yeah, so just a cute little pewter box.
Somebody said that you are their hero. Isn't that sweet?
Margaret, you are my hero in terms of this kind of item. I would not know any cute. Oh, thanks! Are you talking about the globe? This one?
Going back to the globe again.
What? I'm going to just roll it on my face.
Okay. Thank you for not stomping on the bees. Thank you.
Oh.
I'm glad I can influence somebody.
Don't stomp on the bees.
Yeah, don't stomp on the honeybees. Or any bees for that
matter. She's a bee girl.
Okay, sorry.
What about the killer bees that chased you?
No, the killer bees are different.
She got chased.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. Down here in Texas, we have Africanized honeybees, so you have to maintain your colonies and make sure that the Africanized bees don't take over your honeybees, because they will take down a cow.
Yeah. Mm. Or a little skinny you.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Dogs and cats, they took them down quick.
Yeah. Okay, next. Ready?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so this I also got from the guy. I think I spent $3 because I just got little trinkety things.
Three bucks?
I'm going to have to go back because we were doing a ride. We did a ride-along. So I'll have to edit that out.
Yeah,
so,
y'all are going to watch the ride-along. I did some really stupid psycho stuff, so I can't believe it. She was recording the whole time.
I'm recording this, always.
And we came up with a really good product for Starbucks, by the way.
We did.
Oh, yeah. We already got a name for it, too.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Okay, so this I also got from him. I'll have to rewatch it and see how much I paid, because I know I said in the video.
Okay.
So it's like a miniature door knocker, right? Clonk, clonk. It works. It was working just a second ago.
Heavy brass.
Here, like that. So, and there's a screw right there that you hang it onto something. So, it screws on. I don't know. So, I don't know if it's like for, you know, like people who do miniature dollhouses or something, or if it's from something else. But I just thought it was really cool. Like a little miniature door knocker, right? Drawer pull. Maybe that's it, Caroline.
Oh,
I bet you're right. Because look, it's like screw back.
And I love your name.
Yeah.
Kelsey Traders. That's cool.
She has a YouTube channel. You gotta follow her.
I need to watch her YouTube channel. Then. Yeah. Cool.
I think you're right, Caroline, because it does like screw. I bet it has like, you know, you poke it through with it. Yeah. You screw it. Yeah.
No, because you're usually drill in the back of your drawer anyway. You know,
People drill when they screw. And...
Oh, you sell quirky items on Quirky. I want to check you out too.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, she's going to give me a little drive around on where all you people are from, so I can see what y'all do. That's cool.
And Celtic Traders, Caroline, you're in Wales, right? Wales?
Yeah, I know. Very technical, right?
Pokey. Yes. Pokey. Pokey. Pokey, pokey. Yes. Okay, speaking of pokey, we got some the Love Dare cards. 40 daily dares. Drilling and screwing, you're cracking me up. Let's read it. Let's read a Love Dare. How about that?
Can I draw?
Oh, you draw. You draw. I'm not doing this to you, whatever it says, because that's weird.
I know. Just imagine that guy you like on Sherlock Holmes. Yeah. Or anybody that you fantasize about.
Hi, okay. Kristen. Uh-oh.
Dare number 17.
Here we go.
Determined to guard your mate's secrets, unless they are dangerous to them or you, and pray for them.
Wait,
talk with your spouse and resolve then demonstrate love in spite of these issues.
This is not what I thought it was.
Listen to them when they share your personal thoughts and struggles with you. And then make out with them.
What?
No, I'm just kidding.
What?
I don't know. Is this like
this is not what I thought it was.
This is more of like a heavenly. The love dare.
Oh, these are more heavenly.
Yeah, heavenly.
40 daily dares.
We can put our own little tags on here.
Oh, it is from a Bible publisher.
Oh.
I thought this was something else.
Well, I still got it confused. It said make them feel safe. Instead, you say make out with them.
Yeah. Just insert some. I was expecting naughty too, Gordy. Oh my gosh. Yeah.
I was going to say that'd be definitely something you put in the Valentine's Day chocolate box.
Gordy resellers, I'm looking at. I know. Okay, that's okay.
Okay. Yes, Wales, the Welsh Valleys.
Yes.
I'm going to go.
Yes. Okay, so yeah, the Love Dare cards, not so much what I thought. Because I showed Randy, I was like, look what I got, honey.
Lover.
Here comes. Oh, lover.
Oh, well, let down. Give that to your grandma. What a waste. Let me write it in there.
Well,
it's pronounced Jawdy Tex.
Jawdy.
Jawdy?
Jawdy. Yeah, we got to get, wait, we either got to go Georgia or we got to go Louisiana.
Oh.
With that, are we going Jawdy? Jawdy reseller, or you're going to bring it down lower and go Jawdy.
Jawdy?
Jawdy, one of the other.
Slow.
Yeah, you got to go. Yeah. Which one you want?
Yeah, which one?
You want Georgia or you want Louisiana?
Okay, yeah. Do you just want some weird back-ass, hey, y'all, what are you doing?
If you're going to make us talk funny, we're gonna bring it.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. I'm sorry. Okay. Real. Okay. Well, we'll do a real low. We're not too low because we are married ladies, but we'll go lower.
So they think we are. Don't tell anybody this. I don't ever come on these videos anymore, so don't share the video, okay? Nobody knows that I'm existing yet.
She's my imaginary friend.
Yeah. See?
Later, I'll watch this like, I swear I was doing a video with my sister.
Bye.
No, Jawdy. It's okay. We get off topic by ourselves anyway. Okay. That's the fun of this, right? Right.
Yeah. Yeah.
I also picked up, probably not worth a ton, but this Paloma Picasso coin purse for 50 cents. It's, you know, got the coin purse. It's got the key holder. Paloma Picasso, made in Italy, genuine leather. Hi. Oh, Becky, you're a Georgia gal. I'm sorry if I'm butchering the accent.
Well, aren't you a peach?
What? Oh god.
See, this is another sample you could take and you just put all your bills in your pocket and only put your change there, so when they're asking for the money and everybody's waiting in line, you're just like, let me look here. Just a minute. Oh man, 50 cents due. Hold on, let me keep taking. You just be like, oh god, hurry up, it's a dollar already. It's like, I don't know if I'm gonna make a dollar or not. Okay, just take it and go. Really? I can have it?
Mix that with the cat pee.
The panther pee. And the crazy cat robe lady thing.
Yes, yes.
The hair rollers and talk like Peggy. And I'm telling you,
it's gonna work.
And some big glasses. Well, wait, I can't see it. Let me How much is that? I don't know. Let me see. I'll think about it.
You should do more accents. Devin would be funny. Can you do a Devin accent?
No.
Okay.
What would Devin be? Tell me. I don't know.
I'm trying to channel Caroline Matthews. Oh, I can't. Oh. Hello, everybody.
No, I can't do it.
Hello.
Is that like Julia Childs or something?
No. She doesn't talk like Julia Childs.
Okay. I kind of sound like Julia Childs.
I know, but I can't do it. I can't.
Okay.
Yeah.
Okay.
Give me a nice thick Irish brogue, though.
Oh, I don't know about that. I don't think I'd be good, but you know, I could always try. Eamon McMurray.
Eamon McMurray.
Yeah. I don't know. Horrible, right? I need to learn that. I need to learn Japanese because I'm gonna go in there raising hell, speaking Japanese, and they're just gonna tell me to please take it and go away. Yeah. Yeah.
Next up in the haul video. Okay. I picked up this pocket Simon for 50 cents. Still in box. So that's cool. I'm going to have to test it out. Again, this would be one that I would put a video in to show that it's working.
You must have had really big pockets in the 80s.
Right?
Mm-hmm. What were you doing?
If you think about those parachute pants, right?
Yeah.
Cargo pants,
not really so much, but yeah, parachute pants, but that would rip through your parachute pants before you could even wear anything.
That's true. Yeah. All right, let's screen share because I did look this one up. We did look up a few things. Okay, so this one, here's one that sold with box for $17.99. Again, bought it for 50 cents, so pretty good. You know, it'll do okay. $14.99 there. I won't put mine on auction, so. $14.99.
But you do.
Look at this
best
one.
Best offer, right?
I do.
You do. Well, everybody does the do.
I do best offer. Look, I want to know why this one sold for $49.99.
Well, that's a 78. What year is that? What's the year that you have? That one.
That's a 78. No, that's a 95.
Well, why is he calling it a tabletop?
Mine's an 87.
He's calling his a tabletop.
Tabletop game.
And yours is a pocket.
Yeah. Mine is
Well,
this is
it looks the same.
78. Mine's a 80. I wonder if he flip-flopped the 87 to 78.
Oh.
Yeah. Okay. Whoa. John says, I'm from the Forest of Dean in Gloucestershire.
Ooh.
Gloucestershire.
I'm not even going to try to butcher it, so I'll leave it.
Gloucestershire.
Okay, that's
and
near.
They refer to everyone as old butt.
Old butt. So is you're just right up the road from Buckfast, aren't you? You know, Buckfast is where Brother Adam developed the bees, honeybees from Buckfast. Yeah. So, you know, they sell Buckfast bees here in Texas for like $300 because Brother Adam developed that honeybee genetics.
Just butt or buddy?
Buddy.
So you call people butt?
Just butt. Hey, butt.
Hey, butt.
Hey, I'm going to use that.
Okay.
Hey, do you say things like, there's a spider in your biscuit?
What? Yeah.
You know that TV show that comes on Sundays on NPR, and they do away with words? And it's like all these different slang words of where it derived and the meaning
I would enjoy
to
that.
It, you know?
I would enjoy that.
I loved
that.
It. And so one of the ones was, there's a spider in your biscuit, you know? Honey, is there a spider in your biscuit? Or, you know,
what
somebody.
What does that mean?
It means that, you know. Did somebody put something bad in your plans or did somebody spoil your plans you know, are you having a bad day because somebody put a spider in your biscuit? I love it. So that's, you know, when my little guy has a bad day, I say, did somebody put a spider in your biscuit?
Like getting up on the wrong side of the bed.
Mm-hmm.
Yep. Yeah. Mm-hmm. I like that.
Yeah.
How long until eBay cuts videos? I don't know. I know they're cutting out the active content. So I'm not sure. If they're going to do that with the YouTube, is there a hitch in your crawl, right? Or is there a hitch in your giddy up?
Yeah.
Yeah.
That, or something with the wheel. I'd have to remember the other one. Or a lot of the beekeepers say when you get overwhelmed with information, because every beekeeper is going to tell you something different here. They'll say, just chew the meat and spit out the bones. Take what you can use.
Yeah. All right, let's chew this meat and spit out the bones.
Okay, what you got? Oh, I like that. I said that was a story of my life.
Yep, this I also got from Mr. I Do Storage Auctions and sell on eBay.
Oh, I don't know. That's just going to be so much. Maybe for you, an arm.
An arm, maybe a leg. Yeah. Okay, and then I picked up. Okay,
ooh,
this.
The goodies.
Yeah, here's my other goodies. Got these from the Heritage Foundation one that we went to. Let me pull these out to you. There's that. Where's the ring? Where's the ring?
Let's start with this one because you've got two of these.
Where's the ring? Is it in there?
I don't see it.
Oh, no.
Okay. Is it still out there?
It may be in the car still. Okay, you see that.
So, Margaret pulled out this magnetic thing to show me that this wasn't gold. So, that was cool to know how she tested her stuff. But it was still pretty cool because it looked like, I don't know, Swarovski crystals maybe that are on this. Rosary.
Ring in the car.
So I don't know how well y'all do with rosaries or anything like that, but they're pretty popular around here.
Yeah.
So she found that. How much did you pay for that?
That was, oh gosh. Oh my gosh. I left the bag somewhere. I'm out of it. Sorry, y'all.
Okay.
Well, it's probably in that box, wherever that other box is.
This one right here?
Either that, oh look, the bag's over there and there. I wonder if the other, the ring is in there too.
Nope.
No? Okay. Yeah. The ring must be still in the car, but we'll talk about the ring. Okay. But it was either a buck or two, because most of their stuff was a buck or two. Okay, so only 11 thumbs up. Oh, thanks, Caroline. Okay, then Elaine knew the maker on this one. I was very grateful that she was able to tell me. So I picked up this
Waxing Poetic is the manufacturer.
And it's marked
the Silversmith.
WP. And she knew that it was Waxing Poetic. It was $2 for this. So it's got...
And I can tell you that that little leather strap came with it.
The leather strap?
That's their style.
Mm-hmm. And then what is that, an S?
Mm-hmm.
And then that's got a heart cross. Mm-hmm. So that's cool. And then, again, we'll have to lift those up.
And just for everybody who joined, Margaret hadn't looked anything of this, in any of the items that she found up. So we're just kind of shooting on the fly. So we don't know how much she's selling everything, but if you have an idea or you know what it's worth, put it up there.
Yeah.
Let us know.
And then $3 for these things. This is another Waxing Poetic silver initial G, which I'll sell, unless you want it.
Oh, well, yeah, I'd love it.
You want it? Mm-hmm. Yeah, you take it. There you go. You take it. For her Grayson, her Grayson name.
Grayson.
Grayson. G for Grayson.
G, y'all.
G. And then these little silver dangly earrings.
Oh, I didn't even know that came in there.
Yeah, those were in there. So I'll have to see. Where's my magnet? If those are...
See, he even said that he'd been using the magnet ever since you showed him how to do this. So now he carries one in his pocket all the time. So
yeah.
See how awesome you are? Oh, I love this little, what do you call it?
My loop.
Mm-hmm.
So these are not going to be silver. These are not real silver. That's cool. Because that little G is, that G is cool.
Is it?
Yeah, that's silver. Yeah.
Okay.
Boop, boop. Boop, boop. Like that. Okay. Then, I'm kicking myself. So we got this ring. We showed this one.
Yeah,
already.
We showed that one, but upstairs.
The ring must be still in the car.
It has to be.
But
you want to run out and get it?
Yeah, I think it's in where I have my lucky rock in the side.
Yeah, I know where your lucky rock is.
And then the keys are probably on the table out there.
Okay. Be right back.
Okay. It must still be in the front seat. Okay, I'll show you something else while she runs and gets the ring. Hi, Misty. How's it going? Uh-oh. I'm struggling while listing my jewelry because I've been scared. Don't be scared. All right, I got another rosary. This one was, I got it at a garage sale. I think I paid $1 for it. So I need to check out to see if it's silver. It's got a little tag that it's made in Italy. What does it say exactly? It says extra strong Italy, like that. And I did not check it out. Let me grab my magnet while I'm here, while I'm waiting for Elaine. Hi, Cindy. Let's see. I can't tell if there's a pull. Let me set it down. Sorry, y'all. This is, it's got a bit of a pull. So it's not it's not silver, but it's still really a really good quality one. So we'll see how it goes on this rosary. And I had one more big thing while my sister went to get... Oh, it's going to drive me nuts. I think I must have set that ring down in the car. We looked it up. We were looking it up with the loop. Okay, so I picked this up also at the Heritage Society's garage sale for $1. and it's Lane & Co., Van Nuys, California. It's not going for as much as I thought. So I thought, oh, it's got a really good like mid-century look to it. And let me, oh, I thought I looked it up. Let me see if I can pull it up for you. No, but the ones I saw that I checked it out, it was only like maybe $15. So not as much as I thought. So I might still, you know, look it up again on Etsy and see. But still, I guess for $1 to $15, it's okay. That's an okay return. And my sister's got some stuff she's going to share too. And oh, it's driving me nuts because so we picked up this ring. You got it or no?
I didn't find it in your car, so
it's probably in my purse. Yeah. Okay, you talk to them. I want to get my.
Okay. I found something else though.
What'd you find?
A little small for my head, but I think it'll work anyway, as long as it don't shrink my brains.
I think so.
I need everything I can get. Hey.
Oh, it's in the. It's here.
Oh, I should have brought her lucky rock. Yeah.
My lucky rock.
Cool. It's pretty cool. I see it. Maybe. She's digging.
I'm digging.
Oh, she put it. Oh, you didn't bring it in the house. Did you show Granddad?
I wonder if it's out. I'll have to show it later if I can't find it here. We have it. Oh, that's going to drive me nuts. Is that it? There it is.
Yeah.
I was like, man. Okay, so finally. So this ring also picked up for $3. I saw it, and then I saw that there was a marking inside in there. I could see the stamp, so I thought, okay, it's probably silver. $3, it's probably, you know, blue topaz. I'll go ahead and pick it up. And then when I looked at it with the loop, it's marked 10K. So I'm going to have to test it out with the gold testing kit and see if it's really 10 karat gold. But then there was another mark too, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so it had a letter A, and it looked like the shape of a diamond or maybe like a logo on there.
Yeah, A, and then like a little diamond, and then a C, and then 10K, and then there's like a number 2, whatever that means. All right. So I'll be looking that up, that little ring, and see what that is.
Oh, yeah. We need to know what that is.
Cool deal. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
Good find.
Good find. Yeah. Because that could pay for everything, depending on, you know.
How much did you spend all together with everything that you found today?
I'm going to have to go back and look.
Okay.
But I would say maybe $30, 35, maybe $35.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. All right. You want to share your stuff?
Sure. Let's see. I collect vintage toys, and I like to put them underneath my Christmas tree as a decoration. So I found this pocket radio.
Pretty cool. Yeah. It's working.
And it's working.
Yeah.
I'll turn it on for you. Raindrops keep falling on my head.
Falling on my head. Now I'm going to have to listen to this till it stops.
I got that for $1, and it works.
Yeah.
You know, it is vintage, so it's a little ragged.
Yeah,
but
it's cool.
All in all, it's still in one piece.
Yeah.
Original parts. I don't know how much this would go for. But, you know, I collect that kind of stuff anyway.
Yeah. You're going to put that under your tree.
Uh-huh.
Looking for the date on it. Made in the USA. Mm-hmm. I don't see a date. Anyway, okay, what else you got?
Okay, so then I found these salt and pepper shakers, and they're made out of cast iron. I guess this would be the set.
Little cast metal ones.
Yeah. I'll let you hold it.
Okay. So there's a rocking chair and a
little baby crib. Baby.
I bet you think they go like this, white together, and that go together?
I don't know, but they were sitting on that guy's shelf like this.
Those
with
two.
The two baby cribs.
And these two.
And the two chairs.
Yeah.
So
it seems like, and they're painted the same, so it seems like maybe they would go together.
Yeah, like a whole set.
Yeah. Okay, cool.
I don't know. I don't know if they're worth anything, but they seem cool.
Jazzy says, if it passed the magnet test and it's marked, do you still test it? I do. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
Just to make sure, because I'd rather test it. It only takes me a second, and then sell it, and somebody gets it, and they test it, and they're like, whoa.
Yeah.
You
don't
said.
Don't want to bounce back on you.
Yeah. So okay. Because with the testing kit that I have, and I have a link to it in the description box below, it just takes a moment. Yeah. Okay, what else you got?
What do you think?
Oh, it's a cactus. It's a cactus.
Okay. I mean, I know not anything like super special, but it is ceramic hand painted. So,
yeah, that's cool.
You know, if somebody's a cactus lover and then they have to add this to their collection, mm-hmm. like me, then yeah.
And she's got a lot of cactus out there. I wonder if did I make a video of the prickly pear cactus jam that we made?
I don't know.
It may be on our Earthworms and Marmalade.
I know we have one over there.
Yeah, because we have a website together that was the Earthworms and Marmalade website that we have. And blog, like a bloggy blog. But anyway, she showed up one time. She's like, look what I brought you. And it was all these like prickly pear cactus. And so we're like, okay, we're going to make prickly pear cactus jam.
That was quite an event.
We're going to learn better. Yeah, awesome. Cute kitties. Yeah, those are cute.
So. I don't know. I mean,
yeah, I like those.
Okay.
They're cute. Okay, what else you got?
Okay. I got the fundamentals of creative thinking.
Nice.
Yeah. I mean, I don't know. I like stuff like that.
Yeah.
And this was 10 cents. How can you pass up 10 cents?
Yep. Rock symbols. That's mm-hmm. cool.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Of the Southwest, yo. I mean, cool. That's just cool. You want some tattoo ideas? There you go.
Coca belly.
Okay. 10 boxes.
Yeah.
I know these aren't vintage, but they were cool.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Casablanca, so, Gone with the Wind, and
Roy Rogers
and Dale Evans.
Mm-hmm.
Yep.
Pretty cool. Good. This would definitely go with her Texas gal treasure.
Mm-hmm.
You know.
Yep.
Yeah. So here you go.
No.
Yeah.
Oh, thanks.
Mm-hmm. Okay. Yeah, it gets to go on my wall.
Cool.
It'll come.
Y'all get to see it all the time.
Yep.
Mm-hmm. We'll find a spot for it back there.
Okay. For the real deal now, y'all.
The real deal.
Should we start with the big one or the little one?
Oh.
Let's go big.
Okay, go big or go home, girl. That's what they say somewhere.
Here it comes.
Hear it? We're going to need help with this.
It's coming.
Okay.
All right.
Here, let me move this stuff. Let me just drop it on the floor. Okay. I'm going to hold the bells because they're clangy.
Okay.
So
now we have a chest plate.
Yeah.
No, I don't know what tribe. And I couldn't tell if it was authentic or not.
Or reproduction. But what we could tell was... Go on.
Well, the beads were glass, and they're all different shapes and sizes, so that told me it had to have been handmade.
Yeah.
It has the metal brass beads, and it has the bone.
Yeah, these are bone, for sure.
Now, anybody out there knows what something like this is worth? I have no idea.
Or what it's... I mean, I don't know that it's authentic, but it may be a reproduction.
Sure, a reproduction.
But definitely. It's still good quality. It's not, because these red beads are glass, like she said. And they're all like unique, like different sizes, different shapes, glass beads. And these are for sure bone pieces, ribbing, or I'm not sure what you call it. And all of the stringing is all leather. All of this is leather in here. Cool, right? Mm-hmm. It was kind of falling apart. So we had some loose beads and yeah, it's really heavy. It's like super heavy.
But you know, yeah. Maggie likes the way things sound. See?
Yeah.
Without
I don't like those bells. The other one sounds better. Okay, let's grab the other one. You can show me the other
one. I'll show you close up because it was falling apart. Here's one of the, I don't know if you can make it clear on there how you would.
The bone, like.
Kiss my grits. And butter my biscuits.
Kiss your grits. Not right now.
Yeah, well, Carol wanted me to say that.
Oh, yeah, okay. So, yeah, there's that bit. Like that. So cool. And then this is one of the glass.
Here's one of the glass beads.
The glass beads. Because they're all, it's part of it was kind of falling apart. So yeah, these are glass beads. It's really cool. Okay, so you want to share the other one?
When I saw that one, this one was sitting right next to it.
Yeah. And same deal. It's really heavy for what it looks like. Bone, and then these are little metal beads. These ones are plastic, though, these blue ones. But then all of this piecing is leather. And the clasp, this was the button for it. It came off.
Yeah, and this looked like, you know, oyster.
Oyster shell, yeah.
So that was on the end of this.
Yeah.
And it's so heavy.
Yeah, it's pretty, and this is one, like, it sounds good. You can hear it. Sounds, you know, yeah. I'm like,
I mean, I know these are all plastic beads because they're all the same size. They're all identical. It feels that way. They're not heavy. But these brass beads and these bones, the bone is not plastic. I mean, I looked at it forever. And then I asked you if you thought they were wood. But no, I don't think it would be that heavy. It might be water buffalo. I have no idea.
But then there was one that was like you could see the flaw in the, here we go. So you could see where it was kind of scraped, like here. So yeah, that's not wood. So anyway, and then all of these straps are just leather. Anyway, so if anybody has any info, and like I say, it's really heavy. It doesn't look like it would be that heavy, but it is.
Look, I can decorate my hat.
There you go.
Yeah.
There you go. So well, yeah, we need to find out some more about them. She paid $5 for both. So
$5.
$5 for this. Yeah.
$1 for the hat.
$5 for this and that.
This and including that. The chest plate thing. So, yeah.
Really cool. Mm-hmm. And like super heavy. Oopsie, there goes one of the bones.
Okay.
Okay. Better set this back down. All so yeah, we'll take a video and we'll put it in the group too and ask them what they think about it and figure out what you're gonna do with it.
Yeah.
It's pretty cool. Isn't it amazing?
Should I take it apart and just sell the lot with beads, or should I leave it intact and sell it the as is? Yeah. Or should I fix it and then sell it? Y'all tell me what to do. Yeah. I need y'all's help on that one.
Let us know what you think. Here's this glass bead.
Or I can get my nose pierced.
We'll do it. You always wanted to have your septum pierced, right? Yeah.
Well, I did, and I took it out.
That's right. That's right.
Yeah, or can, you know, what do you call those? Earplugs?
Yeah.
No, I don't think so.
No.
Okay. That's so that's not my style. Longhorn.
Okay, so I think that's all of our stuff, yeah? Pretty much.
Let's see. Yep, that's it.
So we'll do a quick, you know, video and we'll drop it into the group and see what everyone thinks about it.
Okay.
How about that?
Yeah.
Thanks
for coming. It was so nice to see all your comments. And if we didn't comment to somebody and we missed you, I'm sorry.
And we have 32 thumbs up, 74 viewers right now, one thumbs down.
One thumbs down. Who did it? Why?
Why'd you do it?
Why did you do it? I don't know.
Oh, okay. That works. Okay. So thanks so much, everybody, for coming to watch. And again, this was an unconventional haul because I don't have a whole lot of research up, but I thought, let's do it.
Yeah, and y'all need to look at the video while we're doing the haul and check out our new product that we came out with.
Oh, yeah. Yes. When I did the Okay, I'll have to edit that right along.
Okay.
Kenzie says, okay.
More wood, honey.
More. All right. Thanks, everybody. Right. Thanks for coming. We'll see you later. Bye. Thank you.